Welcome to the new version of Crown Bees, The Buzz On. I'm Dave, the owner of Crown Bees, and
I'm Kellie. I am your customer service representative. When you reach out at info@crownbees.com, that's me.
You're going to get her, and I'm just there, the color, fly by fly. So we're going to be talking today about bee-friendly colors, and specifically what attracts the bee to a yard, correct?
Yes.
Okay. So what is it in general, Kelly?
In general, you're going to want to imagine your backyard and your garden as a bee paradise. What are things, thinking like a bee, that would be attractive to you? Some of the most obvious are flowers. But what about the flowers is it that attracts the bee other than the fragrance? We already know about that.
They smell with their antennas.
And so we're going to be thinking today about the UV light and the way that bees see the world around them.
Okay. So bees prefer what type of colors?
Bees prefer blue colors, but they will take any flower they can get.
All right. I've seen a mason bee on a dandelion just because they're okay. How about butterflies?
Butterflies are the exact same as the hummingbees or any of the other pollinators. They have their preferences, and having a wide variety of options makes that grocery store attractive to them. Make your backyard attractive.
Okay. So just a pile of colors. All right. Mm-hmm. So from the human perspective, we're just throwing colors out there. Okay. But now let's dig a little deeper. Let's go look at how bees see. So first of all, they've got these beautiful, multifaceted eyes. Okay. So they're not just seeing, you know, I guess binocular vision. Mm-hmm. They're just seeing everything. And so we kind of dug a little deep and found an image out there on the internet that showed us, from a bee's perspective, what might, if I'm inside a bee's brain, you know, what do I see? And talking with Dr. Jim Kane, 10 years ago, one of the questions I said was, how far away do bees see? He said clearly about 20 feet. Okay. But, you know, you can see from this picture, there's a variety of colors out there.
Right. There are things that'll catch their attention, and bees will absorb the spectrum of sunlight that's coming through. So like our eyes, we are able to see certain colors, including red.
Right.
Bees are fantastic, but they see other wavelengths. They don't see red, but I see bees on red flowers. So why are they going to those red flowers?
I think they're probably smelling it, maybe.
They're smelling it?
And or they're seeing colors that we don't see.
They are. Some of the colors that they could see include those different wavelengths. We've all seen those pictures online where they have these magnificent runways. So on the flowers, we'll see, for example, a yellow for a dandelion. But the bees are going to be seeing a range of colors because it's the wavelength.
And that we just don't see.
That we just don't see.
Okay. And so what we're saying is that humans didn't evolve to need nectar and pollen. So therefore, we don't see these colors. But the bees evolved with these flowers, and that's their love language, I guess, is, hey, come here.
Yes, I'll give you nectar, and if you take my pollen, we are all good. So
yeah,
they have that date planned out.
Yeah, okay. So one of the things people ask us is, what attracts a bee to a yard? So they started from just a nesting hole wherever, okay? And as they leave, they're looking for probably five things, okay? Yeah. One of them, they need to mate. So the females are going to mate, okay? Then they're buzzing around looking for pollen and nectar.
Checking out the neighborhood.
Yep. They're looking for the cavity nesting bees. They're looking for holes of the right size. So large bees, small bees are looking for the right size hole. They're looking for, we're calling it door material. So a mud-using bee wants to have mud around, or a tree resin bee is looking for a damaged, dug fur.
Right.
And then lastly, we've learned that the bees do fly away at the smell of insecticides and lawn chemicals and stuff. So a chemical-free yard. So those five pieces are what helps the bees fly a nest.
They're looking for a good neighborhood. Just like people, they want to find food, they want to find a good place to live, and they really don't want the smell of the neighbors next door. So they are looking for just a good, happy, safe neighborhood.
Okay. So I'm a bee. Mm-hmm. and I'm trying to find pollen and nectar. What am I looking for color wise?
When you're looking for pollen and nectar and the bee is out there flying around with their vision, they're going to be seeing things, but what they need to see are big groupings. So if we have a great big grouping of one kind of plant, we are setting them up for success. They will have all the different flowers of that particular variety of plant right there. So they can just stop in, grab the nectar, grab the pollen, and then buzz on back home. It's a one-stop shop of what they
Okay,
need, everything in one place.
so that's fine. I'm looking for flowers that are colorful, but now I'm actually trying to start nesting. What colors am I looking for in a bee hole like here?
Now that is where you're going to
No
want
colors at
something
all.
nice and dark.
Dark, right? So they're looking for a
Safe.
protective, safe place. Okay, so as bees are meandering around a yard looking, they're investigating dark places that they could see. Okay, and here. Here's where we have something kind of new. So, what if we brought the bees in to check something out as it could be a flower? We're calling this thing
Bee pop.
bee pop. Okay. And bee pop is small little, here are the colors that we think bees prefer of human spectrum.
Yes.
And then over here, we've up here, move out of the way, Kellie. Okay. So, these colors. That when we phosphor, so help me understand when I'm phosphoring, what's going on here?
So the first thing is very simple. Sunlight is full spectrum. And when we're putting these colors out, one of the things that we can see as humans are the colors. The bees see those spectrums, not the red, but the lower spectrums as well. But when you have a different wavelength on top of that, that's something the bees see that we cannot see. So we do a little bit of a cheat with a black light and
Right.
we can pop those colors so we see them.
Right, so this is not actually that color. It's just showing us there's actually three different frequencies that are phosphoring at different colors. That's why this
Wavelengths. Yep.
green, blue, or kind of red or white, these are just how our eyes are perceiving that black light on there. The bees are
Right.
seeing
It's a big
cool colors.
billboard.
Yeah,
That's a
right.
huge billboard for them to go, whoa, what is that? And because of the iridescence, the fluorescence, what they're going to be seeing is the flowers and thinking, wow, that must be a great place that has a lot of flowers. I'm going to go check that out.
So if we put these little colors on a bee house, we're pretty sure. In fact, there's even a story years ago. Dr. Gordy Wardell was out in the almond industry, and he was looking to trap bees just to find out what type of wild bees were in his area. And so he had blue vein bee traps. It's a type of a trap that's big, beautiful blue, and didn't have enough of them. So he got some brand new ones and put 10 or so out in this one area. And not one bee was found in going to these traps. So he called the manufacturer back up and they said, oh, shoot, we're sorry. We forgot to put the UV dye into this blue color. Got him back in. All of a sudden, all of these bees showed up again. So it just said to me 10 years ago that UV is really a huge attractor to bees. And so, thus, this little invention called bee pop is something that we hope would bring bees to at least explore what's going on around here. Well, there's no smell. That's you fooled me. Oh, but look,
It's a
here
place I can nest.
it's a place that I could nest. Okay, so to kind of summarize then, okay, you said what type of flowers?
One of the best things to do is just go to your nursery, reach out to your master gardeners, reach out to wild ones. We have chapters across the country of wild ones that have native plants and they recommend heirloom plants. These are plants that are great for bees.
Native plant societies,
Absolutely.
going to your local nursery. One of our teammates, Joe DeLugo,
Yeah, he's awesome.
said that he goes into a nursery at various months during the year, and he walks in the nursery and he walks around to find out where are the bees buzzing. So if they're on this one bush flower or whatever, he buys that because he says
Learning
like
from the bees.
learning from the bees and trying to grow for the plants. And so he also, besides just what's buzzing, he walks around and there's small little bees. And so he looks around for just tiny little bees, and he'll also buy those. So when he's in his yard, he's then verifying that most of them are on that type of a plant. And just over the years, he just slowly adds two or three extra plants. And it's kind of a build it and his come. His place buzzed phenomenal. So,
So get rid of some of the lawn each year, add some wonderful plants, ditch the chemicals. We don't need
yeah,
them.
dish the chemicals, right?
And it's better for the bees if they don't have them.
Yep. And consider if you're trying to attract bees, here's a brand new little concept, bee pop. We think it's a good one. Anything else, Kelly?
Reach out at info@crownbees.com, sign up for Bmail. We have YouTube. If there's any questions, reach out to us. We want to engage. We want to be part of your backyard experience with your bees.
Thanks for watching.